Kataegis is a phenomenon that we have found in breast cancers, and it's characterized by localized hypermutation, or a large number of mutations very closely clustered together. Now, cancers have many, many thousands of mutations, and we would expect that these mutations would be dispersed pretty much randomly through the genome. The genome, of course, is 3,000 million bases. So even for a cancer that has 3,000 mutations, you would still only expect most mutations to be every million bases or so. And that's what we see in this plot, which we call a rainfall plot. The dots represent individual mutations, and the different colors are the different mutation types. And we expect most mutations to be clustered around a million base pairs. What we have found in the breast cancers is that we find clusters of mutations that have much shorter intermutation distances, much shorter distances between mutations, and that they can be distributed throughout the cancer genome. Another point to make here is that the colors of the dots are very particular. In this genome, you have a lot of red dots, or C2T mutations, and black dots, which are C2G mutations. But they are distributed through many, many chromosomes in the genome. This is a very particular cancer, which has a very dense cluster of mutations that's just situated on chromosome 6. But these mutations are almost entirely C2T mutations. Because of the nature of these mutation showers, we have called it Kataegis, which is Greek for showers or thunderstorm, because it looks like a mutational thunderstorm. But this localized hypermutation had a few interesting characteristics. They were characterized by very particular mutation types, and there were cytosine changes to thymine, and cytosine changes to guanine, but they also happened at a very particular sequence context. So the cytosines were almost always preceded by a thymine, TPC context we call it. Furthermore, these substitutions were co-localizing with another type of mutation, which we call rearrangements. And this is a phenomenon that's never been seen before, and we could not have hoped to see it before we could look at the entire mutation catalog in these cancer genomes.